Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the beginning of a new season of the Reed Bloomfield Organ Series and the Wednesdays in Wiedemann with Lynn Davis. We have a really exciting series coming up with our Christmas and Pops concert, as well as the three distinguished guest artists throughout the year. And you'll have the opportunity to hear the internationally known Nathan Laube on Tuesday, September 21st. You won't want to miss that program. And of course, tickets can be had at wichita.edu/organ. That's the go-to place for everything that is organ. Today's program takes another look at themes, tunes, melodies. Can you hear the melody? Where does it sound? Does it sound on top, on the soprano? Does it sound in the middle, alto and tenor, or in the bass, the pedal, or sort of mixed up? That's your job. You'll have to listen for it. And we're once again visiting the Holy Spirit, the one of the Holy Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Some of you may remember my recital last April, which featured the work Prelude, Adagio, and Chorale Varie on the Veni Creator, the Holy Spirit, by Maurice Durifle. So we're continuing on with the Holy Spirit. At the beginning today, Nicolas de Grigny, who writes on the Veni Creator, Come Holy Spirit, Lord God. And then at the end of the program, it's Bach, who uses the Veni Sancte Spiritus, also a Gregorian chant, Come Holy Ghost, Lord God, that was transformed. It was a Gregorian chant, but transformed into a hymn tune, a chorale tune by Martin Luther. So that's way, way far back. In between, we have a small, short chorale prelude, also by Bach, very meditative, yet simple, on Before Thy Throne, I Now Appear. Grigny has written a magnificent rendering of the Gregorian tune Veni Creator used in the great hymn at Pentecost, remembering the attributes of the Holy Spirit, fire, wind, water. He gives us five movements using traditional early French registrations. These are like recipes. They're almost inalterable according to the organ we have at hand. Of course, in France, it's just automatic. You pull out the stops, and there's the sounds. First movement, entaille à cinq in the tenor, five voices. You'll hear the entire tune on the great Spanish trumpet here that's played in the pedal. Fugue à cinq, the tune in the fugue subject and in five voices. Duo, a jig, in two voices. Récit de Cromorne, which is a lovely, elegantly elaborated solo with almost a lute-like accompaniment. And then finally, the dialogue sur les grands jeux being all the reeds, the entire brass of the orchestra, and mutations, those are the fraction stops, 2 2/3, 1 3/5, etc. So here now is the hymn on the Veni Creator by Nicolas de Grigny.
Thank you.
manuscript of 18 chorale preludes, works he considered to be his finest. He sometimes even reworked some of things, the compositions he wrote earlier in his life, to make them even finer in his opinion. These are commonly called the 18 Leipzig chorales. We'll be hearing the first and the last of this collection. Number 18, the last one, and supposedly the last piece that Bach ever wrote. Legend has it that Bach, entirely blind in his last months, dictated this ultimate work to his son-in-law on his deathbed. It certainly has that extreme and humble, noble significance of presenting oneself at the very end before the throne of God. The tune is also known under another title used more frequently nowadays, Wenn wir in höchsten Nöten sein, when we are in the utmost hour of need, which goes together with the vor deinen Thron, before thy throne. And then to finish number one of the Leipzig collection of Fantasia with a three-voice toccata, very reminiscent of the toccata in F major, for those of you who know your organ repertoire, three-voice toccata in the hands, and the entire theme in the pedals, in the bass, much like Grigny's first movement, the Anti à cinq, where you heard the entire unadulterated tune in the bass. Bach has taken this Gregorian chant-based tune, Veni Sancte Spiritus, again a hymn to the Holy Spirit, where we hear all the fire, wind, and water of the Holy Spirit all the way through. On the back of your program, you have the entire text of this Fantasia, Komm Heiliger Geist, Herr Gott, Come Holy Spirit, Lord God. Bach uses all the stanzas. It's a very long chorale tune. The hymn is long. And it, of course, ends with, O Lord, through your power, make us ready and strengthen the feebleness of our flesh so that we may bravely struggle through life and death to reach you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And you'll hear that at the very end in the pedal. Hallelujah, very joyous. Of course, there's always joy in Bach's works, as there is tragedy, there is joy in his works. And now, from the 18 Leipzig chorales, number 18, Vor deinen Thron trete ich hiermit, and number 1, Fantasia, Super Komm, Heiliger Geist, Herr Gott, by Johann Sebastian Bach. Thank you.